Run away!
Good afternoon, Anna.
Afternoon, Derek.
Wow, you went through a few puddles on your way here from school.
Nothing a good clean won't fix. Derek, turn it off! Gotta get that fixed.
At least it's a hot day today.
Yeah, I guess. Megami?
I just wanted a drink of water.
A couple more adjustments.
Uncle, you have the ice-erator working?
Almost.
Sorry about that.
Good, good. Excellent. As I was saying, Megami, water is very important for space travel.
Water is essential for all life.
In fact, our bodies are made up of mostly water.
That is correct. Without water, nothing will survive.
But we can't take lots of water with us to Mars because it is too heavy to put on the spaceship.
All water waste is recycled in space.
Even pee and sweat.
Say, what now?
All waste is recycled for drinking and then recycled again and again.
Water is just so precious in space, it can't be wasted.
And this ice-erator is useful how?
Well, first, I need to explain the three states of matter.
Three states of matter?
Yes, everything is matter. And the first state is a solid.
Like this block of ice. It is hard and solid.
Then there is liquid.
Water is a liquid.
Maybe I will have a glass of water.
No, no! We never eat or drink in the laboratory because of the chemicals, and stuff can be dangerous.
And the last state of matter is
gas. This Bunsen burner is creating a lot of heat energy that can turn liquid into a gas, just like your kettle at home.
I see. Solid, liquid, and gas. So the ice-erator turns water, a liquid, into a solid ice.
Yes, yes. The ice-erator automatically turns water into an ice cube and instantly can reverse the process.
The shape of these ice cubes make them easy to transport and store when we find ice or water on Mars.
And when we need water, we can use the ice-erator to turn the ice back into water.
I could use that ice-erator to capture that little furry alien and then study its growing powers so I can create my huge Quokka army and take over the world!
Gerald! No popcorn! Gerald! Derek, code orange!
Code orange, code orange, code orange.
Anna, what happened?
It's Dr. Poacher again. He's captured Gerald.
He never gives up. But we'll never give up protecting that little guy.
Gerald is encased in an ice cube rolling down the hill.
Ice cube? Rolling down the hill?
My plan is working perfectly!
Bring that alien to me!
Gerald seems to have accelerated. He is now going 70 kilometers per hour.
How is he going that fast?
He must be in a car.
I think we might need this.
That mini ice-erator hasn't been completed. I cannot guarantee optimal results.
It will have to do.
Do you mind if I get a drink of water before we go?
No time to lose.
Ice Cube Gerald will be coming up in a couple of seconds. 3, 2...
There he is!
Is that Sally, the gardener's ute?
Quickly, place the ice-erator here.
We need to get a lot closer.
To have water hidden somewhere in this car, do you?
Sorry, only antidote.
Run away!
We need to get this antidote to Gerald and make him normal again. Uncle, pull over there! I'll go ahead and try and get in front of them.
How are you going to stop the ute?
I'll think of something.
Ah, that ball of alien fluff is too heavy. Just a little further, and I will lose them, and he'll be mine.
Okay, Uncle always says to use the scientific method to solve problems. Step one, make an observation. The ute is traveling really fast. I need to stop the ute and get the antidote to Gerald quickly to change him back to normal size. Step two, ask a question. How do I stop the ute and get this liquid antidote to him before he causes any damage? Step three, make a hypothesis. That's it. If I use the water in the scooter and spray the ute as it goes past, then my uncle can shoot the ice-erator and the ute will become encased in ice and stop, turning a liquid into a solid. Uncle, get ready to shoot the ice-erator at the ute.
But there is no water to turn to ice.
No time to explain. Shoot on my signal. Step four, the fun step. Test your hypothesis.
A liquid to a solid! Well done, Anna!
Oh no! The antidote is solid ice!
The antidote won't work when it is solid ice!
This Bunsen burner is creating a lot of heat energy that can turn liquid into a gas!
I've got it! My uncle said that a lot of heat energy is needed to turn water into gas. Megami, turn the ice-erator up past liquid. Then target it just above Gerald. I will throw the ice up and you shoot it. It should turn into a gas.
But Anna, past liquid? The ice-erator isn't designed to turn a solid into a gas. Only a solid to a liquid, then back to a solid.
I see. With enough power, the ice-erator might be able to change the solid straight into a gas.
That's right. Ready? Now!
Step 5, conclusion?
The ice-erator successfully turned the water into ice, stopping the ute.
And the ice-erator turned the solid ice antidote into a gas. Well done, both of you. This gives me even more ideas for the ice-erator. Solid to liquid and then to a gas. What a discovery. No!
Next time, Eggtop, that little creature will be mine again. Mine, I tell you. Mine!
I think we need to fix some things before going home. Who wants some ice cream?
I would just like a drink of water, please.